Hey everybody, this is my version of a copy carver. It is fairly basic design. I haven't seen anybody else with one like this, but the principle is the same. So pretty much I got it on a big piece of 2x4 MDF, 3/4 inch, keep it sturdy, and it's got some 2x2s underneath. Just raise it off the ground a little bit, and basically it's just 1/2 inch steel pipes mounted on vertical uprights like this, and I could change it to any height within an inch. And that basically, this whole unit here slides back and forth on these two rails on this side. And that controls my y-axis position. So I also have it so it slides left and right for my x-axis and up and down for my z-axis. And these two I got on the y-axis, you got little bolts and nuts to lock it down if I ever want to. Same here, I got it right there. And I also have another feature, which is underneath is a threaded rod that connects to the y-axis position movement. And if I turn this handle, it moves the whole thing forwards or backwards. And I gotta connect it with the chain back there. You can kind of see it. A couple of gears. And that allows the two sides to move in the same position at the same rate. So basically, what I do is I got my banjo neck here. Is I use the feeler gauge and move it back and forth, and it cuts on a piece of wood stock the exact same thing with the router bit right here. So I got a few extra tips. I just welded on a nut onto this threaded rod, and I got a couple different sizes depending on which router bit I want to use. And that's how I got away with that, and that's pretty much it. I also have another feature on this that is a way to cut out circles or round things out. It's basically just a piece of plywood with the dowel sticking out the back, and I have a hole in the table. And you turn it, and it cuts like that. And basically what I did is, you know, I set it for my height so it doesn't go up or down, and I lock that in place, those two bolts. And then pull it forward to where you want to cut, turn it, make a cut, turn a little bit more, make a cut. And it's actually really precise. It's precise enough to do routing on resonators for binding or anything else. And I used it to cut out my banjo rim. And I also have, I haven't made it yet, but working out on my resonator. So basically I have these wooden blocks that are shaped to the contours of a resonator. This one's for the inside. This one's for the outside. And basically what I'll do is I'll set it up like this. And it'll raise up. And I'll turn this to cut out the resonator, pull it forward. Cut a little bit more and turn it, and it should cut out a shape, and I'll film myself doing that as well. Here's my rim that I made using my circle cutter on my with my router, and I did all of it with the router and I sanded it, and as you can see, you know, it fits, the tone ring fits on there nice and snug. And the resonator flange goes on just like that. So there you have it. It's possible. And as you can see, I have my resonator all carved out now using my router and my circle cutting jig and those block templates that I made. It is domed on the inside. You may not be able to tell it right now from here using the camera, but it is. As you can see, I used jig to
create a platform for this to sit, for the resonator flange to sit nicely in. And I just made it out of the block wood construction. It started out as probably about 20 different pieces of wood. This part's all one piece, but it doesn't really matter because I'm probably going to paint a mural in here. And on the outside, I'm just going to put veneer. And if you wanted to make it so you wanted to protect, just maintain the beauty of the wood and do that, I would recommend getting it close to tolerance and then sanding it smooth. I got a little bit of bumps and stuff in here. And I also used a drill bit to route this out on the inside. It's pretty tough getting the router bits that are maybe at the most 2.5 inches long inside this. So drill bit works great with a regular point, no brad points. I found out that works worse. So regular drill bit, 1/4 inch or 1/2 inch if you have a router like that. So here it is all put together. It's mostly done. Obviously I'm going to veneer it. And because I'm going to paint a mural on the inside and veneer the outside, I really don't care what it looks like right now. I put a little bit of epoxy resin in there and make it stronger. And it's not overly thick. It's probably about 3/16 of an inch thick right here. And that's about it. If you have any questions, feel free to email me. And in the next section of the video, I will go have a little video montage of me carving out the back. Have a good one.
Sing my songs, it's getting hard to get over.